Yes, sir.
Ikaw, Bianca, you started at a very young age, no?
Yes, sir.
I mean, 13 years old.
Yes.
When did you realize that, oh my goodness, I could monetize this.
Yeah.
I could make money. And this could be my livelihood.
Yeah, actually, at first, parang ako lang po talaga. I really love playing video games, just like what I've mentioned. Gusto ko lang nagdodota. And siguro, yung first time na na-realize ko na parang may something na dito, parang magiging pwede siyang viable career.
Mm.
Na nung student po ako, nagkaroon po ako ng sponsorship na laptop.
Oh.
So, doon ako nakapag-games and nakapag-gawa ng projects. And then after that, parang binigyan na ako ng cash. So, syempre, when I was still in high school, ang laki na po nung pera nun for me. And then, sabi ko, okay lang, gagawin ko lang din yung gusto kong gawin. And then, parang bonus na lang yun kung may dumating pang mga ganong opportunities.
For people, our viewers who are watching us right now, can this really be a livelihood? Can this be a full-time job?
Yeah.
Manjin?
Yeah. Right now, I think in the generation today, it is. Kasi if I'm not mistaken, may course na nito eh.
Yeah.
Diba?
Sa Lyceum.
Lyceum, may course. Ang dami ng job opportunities. Not just by just being a pro.
Mm.
Like for example, isa rin ako din as a shoutcaster or maybe as a broadcast director, graphics, logistics.
Sir, different marketing. Careers.
Different
yes,
careers
sir.
Ay nagiging open na. Kasi nga it has a league. It has marketing involved, everything.
Advertisement. Public relations. Mm.
How do you manage that?
Management ko in terms of that, lagi kong iniisip palagi, I have my life in game and outside gaming.
Mm.
At the end of the day, I'm still a streamer and bunsong anak ako ng family ko. Isa akong mabuting kaibigan and ayun, lagi ko siyang, hindi ko siya inaalis sa isip ko.
And you are at the forefront of also helping gamers keep themselves fit and active. Gamers Run Club. How
yes,
did you start
sir.
This?
Yeah.
And why did you start it?
Yeah. Actually, sir, nag-start to, hindi naman kasi secret na yung pandemic nag-cause talaga ng boom in the esports industry.
Mm-hmm.
Ah. And then na-realize ko, after pandemic, yung mga tao, bumabalik na sa normal lives nila. Nagsa-start na silang makipag-socialize and lumalabas, gumuguha ng physical activities. And for me, sabi ko, paano kaya paggagawa ko ng isang club na makakapag-promote ng health and wellness among gamers?
Yes.
Kasi I really believe that having this physical activities can help you to have this mental state na makakatulog in-game and outside gaming. So ngayon, luckily, meron po kaming Gamers Run Club na every run namin, 100 yung gamers. And nakakatuwa
wow.
kasi
wow.
90% beginners.
Mm.
And nagsa-start pa lang. Walang
and do you coach? Do you coach potential esports athletes?
Manjin? Mga, usually kapag may mga bagong pumapasok na nagtatanong, especially in the mindset. Kasi nga, yung mga screams ng mga gamers, I've been to one boot camp na eh. Tapos nakita ko na yung screams nila. It, parang 8 hours a day yung game eh. So it's really draining. And minsan paulit-ulit yung game eh. Parang paulit-ulit eh. So you need to at least, kahit paano, ma-inspire sila to work harder. And again, to balance everything out. Kasi nga naman, hindi lang naman din sila naglalaro, diba? And some of the players kasi, nagsa-start out ng sobrang babata. Like for example, si Bianca, diba, 13? Diba, may mga 14, 15. So, kailangan pa nila ng gabay. Kasi nga, we live also on social media. Minsan, pag natatalo sila, may mga haters kaagad na pumapasok. Diba, hindi mo naman kasi shinut eh, yung mga ganun. So, minsan, hindi pa nila alam paano i-handle yung ganung klase. So, may mga ganung mindset conditioning po na involved din siya.
Manjin, Bianca, we're so proud of you. I mean, you're very successful celebrity streamers. Thank you so much for joining us on Beyond the Exchange. You are truly role models for the up-and-coming esports athletes.